Hey guys, welcome back to my channel and welcome back to another video as part of Everyday May. Today I wanted to go back to wardrobe basics and talk about the 10 pairs of shoes that I think are worth having in your wardrobe. Now do keep in mind, this is just based on my own personal style, so the 10 pairs of shoes you think you should have in your wardrobe may vary slightly, but I'm gonna just dive right into it. Everything that I mentioned will be linked down in the description box below, and I might also link my designer dupes blog post as well, just in case you wanna get some high quality shoes that look like their designer counterparts, but at a fraction of the price tag. The first shoe that I wanted to focus on was the pointed toe or ballet flat. Now for me, a really chic flat shoe is sort of one of the heroes of my closet. It's something that's very practical and that you can pair with a very smart outfit but won't drag down the look. The pair that I've got that I wear very frequently are from Everlane. These are their editor flats and I do love these. The elastic on them does stretch, you keep that in mind. I still need to take mine to the cobbler because the strap on, I think it's the right foot, does slip off my heel slightly, but these just really elevate my outfits and they're a really great option for me when I don't want to wear a heel. If you're looking for a great pair of ballet flats, I really cannot recommend Porcelli enough. I have owned two pairs of ballet flats from Porcelli in the past, so I can definitely speak to the quality of them. They are very well made and super comfortable straight from the get-go, so a great option if you can't wear a pointed toe flat or you prefer something with a rounded toe. The next pair of shoes I wanted to talk about are the ankle boots, and these for me are an incredible autumn wardrobe essential, something that I reach for all the time as soon as the weather cools down. But for a lot of people, especially if you live in a location where the climate is relatively mild or at least cool a lot of the year, then you may find yourself reaching for ankle boots a lot more frequently. I've got two pairs that I want to share with you guys. The first pair are these ones here from Everlane. These have a little bit of a block heel to them and they do have that zip up closure. They've got the pointed toe. Now one thing you will notice with both pairs of these boots is that they both have a pointed toe. For me, it's something that I like because I feel that it draws the eye down further and really elongates your leg. So that's my preference. However, a round toe is also a beauty. If you've got a great classic Chelsea boot, which I will link some down in the description box, those are always a great shout as well to have in your wardrobe. But I do think a good little pointed toe, something in black, is always really nice and classic and that you'll be able to wear it for years and years. I think I've had these ones for going on to 3 years now. And then the other pair that I wanted to share are these ones here from Mark Fisher. And these are an incredible dupe for the Acne Studios Jensen boots, which I have coincidentally also owned. And I think you can get away with these ones. They look basically exactly the same and they are just as comfortable. These are, I would say, more of a stylish twist on the classic Chelsea boot. So it does have that elasticated panel down the side. However, it is more angular rather than being rounded. And these ones here have a very low heel, so very, very comfortable for walking. Being in a suede though, and a very light suede, they are a bit more delicate than their leather counterparts, so if you are going for something like this, you will need to make sure that you use some kind of leather protectant or suede protectant on them. I use Colonel, and I will link the spray that I use down in the description box below just in case that's helpful for you, but I do think a good neutral boot is a good option to have in addition to having a pair of black staple boots. My third pick is a workwear classic, and that is the black pointed toe court shoe. Now, I have talked about this quite a few times in numerous workwear videos, but I feel like this is a very good staple to have on hand. They're very smart, they're elegant, they are refined, and they elevate your outfit. And I just find that they really polish off a workwear look. The ones that I have are quite old. They're from Isabel Marant, and they do have a little bit of a bells and whistles on them. They've got the bow detail. I would recommend something a lot more classic, particularly if you do work in a corporate environment. Something in a black leather is very easy to maintain, very easy to care for, and that is very plain, so no details across the toe. That would be my recommendation if you're only going to get one pair, so a good one to have. And I always find that a shoe like this you can also take out for special occasions as well. They are really good for wearing out on like a date night. You can easily transition them from work to bar. So for me, a black pair of court shoes is a definite must in my wardrobe. Let's talk loafers next, and I've got two pairs again that I want to share with you guys. I just wanted to show you a couple of different options because there are so many alternative styles out there that you could go for. I personally really love the classic horse bit design. Now these are from Sam Edelman and they are styled after the Gucci loafers, which everyone and their mum seems to have. They're very, very popular at the moment, but they're also undeniably classic. And I can understand why they have become so ubiquitous, because they are just the type of shoe that you'll be able to wear for years and years. They are just not going to date. So what I think really makes these special is that gold horsebit detail across the vamp. I just think that it's very stylish, and these have more of a masculine edge to them. So they are really great for pairing with jeans in particular, or trousers if you want to make it seem a little more gammon. The other pair that I have are a more softer style loafer, and these feel a little bit more feminine than the ones from Sam Edelman. They are the Day Loafer from Everlane. Now, I got these gifted to me and they are very comfortable. They are a narrow fit though, I will say that. So if you have been looking at getting a pair of these, you probably find that they're best for you if you have a narrow foot rather than a wide foot, but they are comfortable and true to size. I love having a caramel option just because I feel like it's a bit warmer, a bit lighter than the black pair. And these ones here, because they do have that slightly more rounded toe and they're much more of a streamlined fit, they work really well with dresses and with skirts as well. So these are more of an option that I feel that I can mix in with the majority of my wardrobe. They don't have that horsebit detailing across the vamp at all, so they've just got that one little seam there, which I think helps you create a bit of detail. But otherwise, this is another loafer option for you guys. The next shoe that I feel is so worthwhile having in your wardrobe is a nice pair of mules. And I've got another two pairs. I just wanted to show you guys different styles because there are so many varieties on all of these different shoes. So this pair here I've got is from Tony Bianco, and these are, again, another designer dupe. These are a dupe for the Row Coco Mules. So these are a little bit special because they don't just have the slip-on part of the shoe, but they've also got this bow detail which sits across the front of your foot, which I think is very ladylike and very elegant. I like the fact that these have more of a kitten heel, which is something that I've seen very, very common with mules, and I think that's part of what makes them really comfortable and is part of their appeal, is that they are so easy to walk in, and I find that they are such a simple pairing with so many outfits. These ones in particular, because they do have that very pretty feminine detail, I find work very well with dresses and skirts, but they also look incredibly chic when paired with jeans as well to add a more feminine in touch. The other pair that I have are probably what you would consider more of a classic mule style. So these are a pair of mule sandals from Marks & Spencer, and these have that block heel, which is what makes these so easy to walk in and what makes them so comfortable. So even though they have quite a bit of height on them, and I would say that these are probably about 3 inches high, they are very comfortable to walk in, and these are a really good summer option because your toes are free and you do have that very minimal design. So these aesthetically I think are absolutely beautiful, but there are so many options like this, even ones that have just got the simple strap across the front of the foot. Mansur Gabrielle do a very beautiful one, and I know there are some more affordable options out there as well, so I will link some of my favorites down in the description box. I thought it might be fun to continue along the theme of more summer appropriate shoes. So the next pair of shoes that I think you should have in your wardrobe is a great pair of summer sandals. For me, these are just a necessity as soon as November hits, even earlier than that in Sydney, because it does get so hot here. And I've got two different variations that I really love. I personally really like getting sandals that are in more of a natural tan or beige option rather than black, just because I feel like summer is a time to sort of, I guess, embrace more of those warmer natural tones, which is definitely what I've done with my own shoe wardrobe. So the first pair I wanted to share are a very old one and unfortunately no longer available, but these ones are from Sportscraft, and they've got this snakeskin print across the toe, and these pair effortlessly with absolutely everything in my wardrobe. You wouldn't think it, but snakeskin is definitely a neutral, and these are also very on trend because animal print and snakeskin in particular is a big fashion focus for the current season. I like the fact that they do have that nubuck suede portion at the back, so these are more of a slip-on style, very, very comfortable, and a great one because they also elongate your legs as well, because they leave the front of your foot free. The other pair of sandals that I have are a braided pair from Boden. And these ones here are in much more of a richer, darker brown, which I think is just gorgeous and looks great with a tan, or even if you don't have one, I find that brown is a much more flattering option than going for black, which can look quite stark, especially if you are on the fairer end of the spectrum. I personally really love this braided design, and these are so comfortable, you won't believe it. I think I walked 25,000 steps the first day that I wore these, and I didn't get a single blister, so that was a major win for me. So these ones are a little bit different to the Sportscraft one in the fact that they've got two straps, so one at the toe and then one a little bit higher at the foot, and then they also have this little ankle strap detail which secures your foot into the shoe. So these are another great option. They aren't going to be as leg lengthening as the other style that I showed you, but very, very comfortable and very practical, especially if you're going to be doing a lot of walking in the summertime. Talking about walking, my next shoe recommendation would be to have a great pair of sneakers in your wardrobe. These ones here that I have are from Veja, and they were a very kind birthday gift from my husband. I absolutely adore these, and Veja was a brand that I was so curious to try because I'd heard wonderful things about them, plus they are ethically and sustainably made. So I believe every single part of the shoe is biodegradable, which is fantastic, and I will link to their website down below in case you guys want to go and check them out. But I think a great pair of trainers that you can wear with everything, so with more dressier options but then also just more casually on the weekend, is great. Something that is going to be comfortable, that is going to be high quality, and that you're going to be able to wear for years. So these ones here are a nice classic fresh white option, which I personally like because I feel like they're so easy to wear and very easy to clean too. You just got to wipe them down with a damp cloth. So those are my sneaker option. The ninth pair of shoes I think are worth having in your wardrobe are heeled sandals, and I've got three examples to share with you guys. You can tell I really love shoes, I'm sure. These ones here, the first ones I wanted to share, are from Everlane, and these are a double strap sandal. So they have that nice chunky block heel, which are very, very comfortable for walking in, and then they've got two very thin straps. So what I like about these is that they have a bit of detail across the foot, and the fact that they have the strap before the ankle rather than around the ankle, I do find can be quite flattering. And being in a new color, they're a little bit more leg lengthening than if they were in a black, which I do find can cut you off slightly sometimes. Now what I love about these is that they are so practical. So these are the kind of sandal that I think you could easily wear for a special occasion, but you can also wear them more casually just because the style of them is pretty simple. They're no frills, you know, they're quite minimal. So for me, I have worn these a lot with denim and they look very, very chic. I like the fact they have that contrasting heel, and they also look amazing with dresses and things like that. I mean, a sandal like this is just such a no-brainer. It's gonna go with your entire closet. The next pair that I've got are slightly similar, but these are a bit more splurge worthy, and I did just want to kind of point out this style a little bit more for how you could have a dressier option on this shoe. So these ones here are from ATP Atelier, and they actually have a strap that goes around the ankle. Now the key to finding an ankle strap sandal like this that is going to be flattering rather than cut you off is to find ones that the strap hits a little bit higher than your ankle. You don't want it to be right on your ankle because I find that it widens your leg, and actually, like I said, it visually cuts you off. It makes you appear shorter. If you find one that comes a little bit higher up, there's a bit more balance there because you can see the narrowest part of your leg. So this particular pair, they do sit a little bit higher. What I like to do is I only will do it up to the second notch because I find that that way there's a little bit more room around my ankle, and again, it makes them look more flattering. If you have to do them up so they are so tight around your leg, they're not only going to feel uncomfortable, but they are, like I said earlier, just going to completely cut off your leg, make you look shorter, and be quite unflattering. Now, if you wanted a more dressier take on a shoe like this, what I would suggest is getting a pair that has more of a stiletto heel. These ones have a block heel, which makes them very easy to walk in. However, they aren't really what I would class as being a dressy shoe. So I would get one that's got a very nice stiletto heel and very thin straps. So no buckle details or anything like that, just something very simple. I will link some options down in the description box below because there's so many of them out there, and they're a great option if you're looking for something to wear with a nice dress if you're going out for dinner or for drinks during the summer months. The final pair of heeled sandals I have are these ones here from Charles & Keith. So these are more of a slingback style. These ones are not going to cut you off visually at all because the front of your leg is going to be completely bare. So these will have more of a leg lengthening effect and are definitely perfect if you want to wear something more for a fancy occasion, or else they work really well for dressing up a pair of jeans, which is personally one of my favorite ways to wear them. So if the setup's changed slightly, I realized after I finished filming that I forgot to include one of the pairs of shoes, so I'm just going to quickly do that now before we dive into the last pair, and that is the nude or neutral pointed toe pump. So I've got these ones here. These are from Everlane, and again in a suede fabric. Personally, I find that suede is really great for me because I do have a bunion on my left foot and I also have wider feet, so suede just tends to be a little bit more forgiving because it is a much more softer material. I personally love these because I find that they are much more leg lengthening than their black counterparts. However, they are just as chic and just as professional, so a good one to switch in or out if you don't want to wear a black pump every day, or you find that you're wearing a lighter outfit and you want something that's a little bit more complimentary. Then the final pair of shoes that I think are worth having in your wardrobe are a great pair of over-the-knee boots. And I know personally I was very late to the party on this one, but around Christmas time I did manage to snap up a pair of Stuart Weitzman over-the-knee boots on sale for, I would say, a little bit over 50% off, which I personally thought was a very good deal. Now, what I love about a great over-the-knee boot is that they have a dual purpose. One, they add a really interesting styling element and a great way to layer up visually, but also they are incredibly practical because they add a layer of warmth to your outfit. So a really good option to have, particularly if you do live in a colder climate and are always struggling to keep warm. Something that maybe has a flat sole instead of a heel would be a great option. I know that Stuart Weitzman also do a flat boot as well, and ones with chunkier heels. I personally just like this thin heel just because I wanted something that was a little bit more elegant and refined. But the way that I wear mine is paired with skinny jeans. However, you could also wear them with mini skirts or with a little mini dress as well. And I also have seen people pair these under longer skirts and longer trousers as well, just for that added layer of warmth. So those are the 10 pairs of shoes that I think are worth having in your wardrobe. I'd love to know if you think I missed anything out. Please let me know your favorite pair down in the description box below. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you tomorrow with a brand new video. See you then. Bye.